What's up, everyone? Peace. What's up? Hope all is well. Just had to put my phone on silent real quick. Hope all is well. I'm gonna wait a few minutes so everyone can enter in. So if you're watching this and it's not live, I'm gonna wait a few minutes. I'm gonna talk about some very important things. Every time I get messages, every time I get information, anything that jogs my memory, or comes to me, whether it's myself, my spirit guides, my higher self, I jump right into doing a video because I get bugged. If I don't do it, it gets bugged in my head over and over and over. Make sure you do this. Make sure you talk about this. Make sure you say this. Make sure you say this. Again, as always, like I said, if you have not downloaded this Quantum Frequency app, I suggest you do it because this is one, it's an app from Future Technologies. I know the developer, and this is an app that you want to have on your side that you listen to every single day and every single night, because it'll put your body in alignment the way that it should be. So I'll just wait a few more seconds, like I said, until the people get into the room. They're trying to put the notification out there. One of the ones that I'm putting on right now is called the high vibrational frequency, raising your vibration. So I'll let that play for a second.
Shifting your frequency at cellular level, preparing your body to hold more light.
And this is what it looks like when you play the app. It's got the Merkaba symbol. So remember, signals, symbols, and frequencies all correlate together. It's not just sounds. So all of this actually has to do with body frequency. And I've been playing with this app for a while, so it's definitely a good app to go off of. This is one of the crystals that I've been rocking with. That's funny, rocking with. It's in the quartz family because it's clear. And I really like this one because it reminds me of crystals are always fallen entities. Don't forget that. This one kind of looks like a body part. Maybe it was an arm or a leg. And it also has a fingerprint here. A few prints. So I keep this one on me. This one's been giving me like real high vibrations. I may just start talking because I don't, if a person's watching this and it's not live, I don't want them to just be waiting around. So when they come in, they will come in. So I'm going to jump right into, I'll turn this down so it's not too loud. I'll jump right into what I was going to talk about. Okay, so first things first, if everybody gets the opportunity and they get the chance to, go watch the film called Concrete. Go watch the film called Concrete Cowboy. What's good, Jalen? Appreciate you being here. Share this video if you can so the algorithm picks up and everybody knows. Because I know it takes a little minute for it to get out there. But the more we share the video, the more people actually know to get out there. So I appreciate you being here. Good to see you again, brother. But what I was going to talk about was, first thing before I get into it, there's a film on Netflix called Concrete Jungle. And this one's by Lee Daniels. And it's a story about basically the black cowboys and cowgirls. And it tells the hidden truth and the hidden story and the meaning behind who we once were before they labeled us as slaves and everything else. So the one thing that I actually like about what's going on in this reality sense is the truth is actually coming out to where shit that they didn't tell us about us before, they are now telling us. And I just actually posted a short clip. It's like 2 minutes and 30 seconds about, there's a scene in there where they explain how Hollywood whitewashed a lot of stories that were supposed to be about us. But unfortunately, when you really think about it, if we're not the ones telling the stories and another species is, then they're always going to get it wrong. So in this day and age, what we're doing now is we're coming back into power to where we're writing our own history. We're telling our people the true nature, the true meaning, because unfortunately, everybody was brainwashed to believe that we were nothing but slaves, which is complete bullshit. You know, we've all heard the stories while we were going through school, through college, they lied and said we came from Africa. All of us came from Africa, which was a lie. Okay, a lot of us originated here on this land, on this plane. You know, even if you look at your ancestry DNA, which I really don't, a lot of that is a lie, but majority of it is true. We originated here on this land first before it was taken away. We were the original Indians. We were the original Aborigines. We were the ones who were here first before the invasion happened and it was taken over, amongst other locations. So, you know, like I said, the history books, which means his story told by false beings that wanted to push us away, they're the ones who told the biggest fabrications, which they took us and wiped us clean like we never existed, and they put themselves in our place. Just like the Indian story, okay? The whole Dane Calloway, if you don't know who that is, go look him up on YouTube. He drops a lot of knowledge. He drops videos talking about where the $5 Indians came from, what $5 Indians are, which basically is when we were here, before we were slaughtered, the white species, when they migrated over here and stole our land and took everything else, all they had to pay was $5, and they were given a certificate to show that they were the original Indians. That's why they were able to take our land. That's why they were able to build on our land. So all of this shit was taken from us. But I tell people, don't worry about what was, because what's coming now is we're all getting that shit back. The earth, the matrix is resetting to where what's owed to us will be paid in full. And a lot of people don't even realize, I found this out, our social security and our birth certificate actually comes with a bunch of predestined money that's for us. That certificate actually is our birthright to this land. But a lot of people don't realize that our social security number and our birth certificate was sold off to a lot of these corporations. So there's a link that I have to find, but someone shared it with me, and you type in your social security number and it lets you know how many companies are actually using your information to sell it. Because originally what was supposed to go on was our birth certificate, our birthright, anywhere we go on this land, that is like a deed to where, let's say, for example, every single one of us has $1 billion under our name. We're walking cash cows to where we're originally supposed to go wherever we want, and not pay any money. If we want a car, we're supposed to be able to take our birthright, birth certificate, go in there and say, this is what I want, no matter how much it is, and not pay a damn thing. Show our birthright, and they would take the funds from that certificate, almost like a trust fund. But again, like I said, they miseducated a lot of our people, and our information is being sold and bought off by these corporations. So that truth is going to come out. There's a lot of stuff, like I said, that's supposed to be coming out that people don't realize. But the main thing that I wanted to talk about was manifestation. Right now, we're at a high-ass level where whatever we're thinking about, we're manifesting fast, rapidly. So pay attention to what it is that you're thinking about. That's why they have all these distractions going on social media, on Facebook, on the news. What they need us to pay attention to is their bullshit, which is pre-programming everybody. Because when you look at TV, when you look at anything that has to do with television that is not high vibrational, anything that has to do with that is programming every single one of us by what they're showing us. For example, you know how they talk about the face mask. If you notice, every commercial now shows people with those face masks on. Movies are now showing people with face masks on. Actually, a long time ago, they've been showing a bunch of face masks randomly that your eyes never picked up on, but your subconscious mind was showing it over and over and over and over again, to where every single one of us saw enough of it and it started to manifest. So this is why I say watch what you pay attention to, what you are watching, because since our third eye manifests this reality, since we're the genies in a bottle walking around creating this realm, the artificial race who is on the news, who is on TV, who is the ones who are so-called in control, putting the images and the thoughts and forms and music, all that shit, whatever they're putting out there, they know that we're going to listen to it and we're going to look at it. And the more bullshit they put out there and the more we look at it, we're being programmed by whatever you see in these two eyes. If you continuously watch it and you believe it and you don't have your shit together and your mind isn't free, your third eye is going to put that image out there. That's who we are. That's how we operate. When your third eye is on bang, or even if your third eye is not open, just by the things that you speak about, the things that you think about, you end up bringing about. So anybody who ever comes to me and asks me, should I talk about Matrix shit, whether it's the vaccine, whether it's this or it's that, I tell people, don't talk about shit that don't serve you. Because when you're busy talking about it, when you're busy sharing the information, you're still keeping that system alive. Just like racism, for example. Now they want everybody to focus on the Asian community being ridiculed and being destroyed and being talked about because there's nothing else to talk about. Since Black Lives Matter movement is really not being talked about no more, they need to put another distraction, which is now they're talking about Asian lives matter and Asian Americans have been destroyed. They always have to find something in order to keep us plugged into this system. That's why they're pushing so many different agendas out of nowhere. All you got to do is pay attention to it. One minute they want to talk about toilet paper running out, so they make everybody go and buy toilet paper, toiletries, and all this other hand sanitizer bullshit because they need people to believe something. So therefore, you're throwing all your funds and your money into it. And now you end up wasting a whole bunch of time and energy, and everybody's running to go believe some bullshit. And if you look at it today, did we run out of toilet paper? No. Have we ran out of anything? No. It's all a hoax. Anything that they say on the news, anything that they are talking about, don't ever believe it, because, again, they need you all to use your fear, the fear that something's going to run out, so you go and pay all your money for it, the fear that certain things are not going to work out, so they need you to go and put your energy towards it. Don't focus and talk about anything that does not serve you. I know I mentioned racism and I got away from that. Notice how long ago was the biggest, you know, Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Jesse Jackson shit that they were talking about that they still want to keep alive today. That's why they pay these so-called civil rights leaders to keep talking about that shit. Because the more that they have them hollering and screaming, the more that they show police brutality and police killings, which, by the way, a lot of that shit is made up. When you show somebody being killed on television, those are crisis actors, because no camera crew is going to be there perfectly on time to record somebody being slaughtered or murdered. Or like the last dude that got his ass so-called killed, who that was a lie, you know, had the knee on his neck and shit like that. Those are all paid crisis actors. Because what it is when you watch things that put you in fear, when you watch things that put you in disbelief, when you watch things that get you revved up and your energy boiling, oh, I can't stand the cops. You're putting all that energy, even though they want you to put your energy towards stuff that doesn't serve you so it stays alive, because you're a walking battery pack. They cannot survive without our energy. And I know most people are busy looking at the flesh, and some people can't distinguish the difference between so-called human and gods and all this other stuff. But if you pay attention closely, if your third eye is open, if you see what you're supposed to see, you can easily tell who's not of this world and who is. I see it all the time. I see fucking people who look like vampires, people who look like demons. All you got to do is pay attention to their eyes, their skin, if their eyes are sunken in. You can tell by looking at somebody whether they have whether they're a living entity or not. I see it all the time. So it's nothing for me to see it. So these same beings, like I said, they need us to fear. They need us to put our energy in a certain direction so we are constantly feeding the beast. You're feeding the beast when you keep running after money. You're feeding the beast when you keep running after cars, shoes, and clothes. You're feeding the beast when you're continuously thinking that when you go out of your house, you're going to die. You're feeding the beast when you fear the so-called police officers, the so-called law enforcement, all that shit. They're all made up. They have no power. They can't do anything to you when your mind is free. Think about this for example. Why do you need to hear sirens when you're driving down the highway? Now, most people would think, well, that just lets us know that there's danger close or there's an emergency. 9 times out of 10, if you think about it, the only time you hear sirens blaring are in melanated neighborhoods. When I was in Los Angeles, they used to always have sirens going off to manipulate manifest, because again, those are sound waves and sound frequencies. When you go into these artificial neighborhoods, the beings that really don't belong here, in their neighborhoods, it's always clean. It's always squeaky clean. They don't send sirens blaring and doing all this other stuff because they don't manipulate them. They give that area, they always want to keep quiet and silent. But if you notice in the so-called ghetto, in the melanated neighborhoods, what goes on? They continuously put information out there that's going to destroy you. Notice where all the fast foods restaurants are in our neighborhoods. Notice where all the liquor stores are in our neighborhoods. Notice where all the destruction, the trash, the so-called ghetto. They destroy our neighborhoods on purpose. A lot of people don't realize that we're not the ones doing that shit. They actually have government official agents who infiltrate. And again, like I said, all skin folk and kin folk. There's a bunch of sellouts out there or people running around in our avatar bodies that have been demonically taken over, but they look like us. Just like when they had that situation going on with Remember when they were destroying the stores and all this other stuff going on, and everybody had on a mask and you couldn't tell who was who, and a lot of people started to point out. Remember when they were destroying the neighborhoods and people started to peep that there were certain individuals who was going and destroying shit? Those are agents placed in there undercover to look like us and act like us and destroy our neighborhoods. So therefore, the news reports it and makes it seem like we're the ones doing that shit. Those are undercover agents. Think about this, for example. Like I said, growing up, do your history. Look at over time. We used to be peaceful. We used to be at peace with one another. We dressed good, we looked good, our neighborhoods was good. They didn't tell you about Black Wall Street in the history books because they know what they did. Black Wall Street, if you do not know what Black Wall Street is, Black Wall Street was bigger than the Wall Street that they have today. It was way more successful. We had our own movie theaters. We had our own doctor shops. We had our everything that you could possibly think of that they have today. We had, and in the bit, our business was booming so much because what was going on was we were sharing the black dollar. We were sharing our currency, our energy amongst each other. We were making each other rich by, if you had your own store, we used to pay each other. So we didn't go to all these big corporation stores like Walmart, Walgreens, Macy's, all these other, stores that don't serve us and shit like that. We had our own grocery stores. So think about this, for example. When you circulate money amongst your own people, you uplift your own community. And it's not hard to do. In this society that we're dealing with now, it's easy to make money. Think about this. You got a Cash App, you got PayPal, you got Venmo. Anybody can make money in an easy way. I've actually started circulating my dollars amongst my own people. If somebody makes if somebody needs to if I had if I need to have my credit cleaned up, I know my own people. I go to them and I give them money. I'm keeping them paid. And then in return, when they need something from me, which is a class or crystals or whatever it is, they come to me and they pay me. If I need real estate, I know a bunch of people who sell real estate. So I'm going to make sure that I go to my individuals, my people, to make sure that they get paid. That's how we are, what we are doing, how we go back to, how we go back into, winning in society all over again. One second. That's how we go back into winning all over again, is by circulating what we have today amongst one another. Now, I want to get off the topic of money for an example, and I want to talk about energy. We need to circulate love all over again. Which means if we're so used to going around talking shit to one another, we need to get out of talking shit to each other, and we need to start uplifting each other, which is love and high vibrational talks. Because remember what I told every single one of you before. Your throat chakra gives off sound frequencies and vibrations. When you hold your hand here and you talk, you can feel a vibration coming off. That is vibrational frequencies that is not only going into your mind, because again, as you're talking, when you feel the vibrations here, it's also trapped inside of your body. So as you're talking, the frequencies from your voice are merging with the blood cells and also merging with the water that's inside of your body. Frequencies and sounds change the molecular structure of your blood and change the molecular structure of the water cells in your body. So if you're 75% water, everything that you're talking about, everything that you're thinking about is transitioning into your body. So if we're so used to talking shit to each other. And the only reason, like I said, we talk shit to each other is simply this. They showed us this in TV shows. They showed us this in movies. How many movies do you see where we're always shown broken homes, broken families? We always talking shit to one another in these films. These are actors. The reason they get people to when you get a very good actor that makes it seem real, you forget for a second that you're actually watching a movie and your brain starts to process that that shit is real because it looks so real. That's what actors are paid to do, because I was one. The more we make it believable for you, the more the subconscious mind gets tricked into knowing that it is believable. This is exactly why I said turn off the television unless you talk and unless you're watching something that's high vibrational in spirit. If anybody was born in the 80s and the 90s, you all remember there was a time before there was negativity. We had black shows that showed success. For example, The Cosby Show showed a black successful family. Bill Cosby was showing black success. He even tried to buy NBC a long time ago, but they shitted on him with a bunch of lies. That's why they took him down in nature, because they didn't want him trying to uplift his people. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air was another one. A successful black family that was shown being together. Family Matters was one. A Different World was one. In the 80s and the 90s, there was a time where we were all shown in harmony and in love, but all of that got twisted around. Once the 90s was the last peaceful era. Once the 2000s hit, that's when shit completely got turned upside down and foolery came into our neighborhoods. Now, what do you have? You have Love and Hip Hop bullshit. You have MTV, which is showing people constantly shitting on each other. You have all these reality shows where, again, I tell people, reality TV are actors as well. So don't pay attention to that shit. Reality TV is not real. They pay every single person to have a script in front of them. They just make it seem real. So therefore, again, they're programming you to believe that there is so much going on in your livelihood. Now, I know that they show drama amongst all races. There are other races that are being shitted upon, but I want to address the biggest downfall, which is our people who have been shitted on ever since the beginning of time. We have been the ones who have been torn apart constantly. We are the ones that have been lied to in our history books. We are the ones who actually had our shit whitewashed. And again, we had a fabrication story shown to us and taught to us from birth. Schools were pretty much prison systems. I'm gonna prove it to you. In school, are you able to leave or you'll get in trouble? School should be a place where you freely decide whether you go or not, but they made it a law that if you did not send your kid to school, aka prison, you got locked up or you got in trouble. They made it a law where you have to send your child with other children to an institution where you have artificial race beings teaching your children bullshit. Even if it was a so-called black school, they gave us shitty ass books, shitty ass teachers, terrible misguided information. And also, like I said, what did they show you in those textbooks? They showed you Benjamin Franklin discovered electricity. When that shit is bullshit. Electricity was never discovered. Electricity was naturally something that we all had within us. We are electricity beings ourselves. We are the ones who control the weather. They don't want to tell you that. then they tell you about dead presidents who so-called freed the slaves or that Emancipation Proclamation. All this shit is storytelling. False information implanted onto every single one of our minds so that we are brainwashed that as we get older, we all keep playing the same thing over and over again. School is designed to train you to be in the matrix. Think about this. How many books do you have to carry around with you in so-called elementary school? They start you off small with ABCs and 1, 2, 3s and songs to sing, which are spells, by the way. Then as you get older into middle school, now they put you in a classroom full of a whole bunch of negative energy. People who come from broken homes, people who fight, people who scream, depending on which school you are going to. If you had the big dollar bills, then they trained you on how to survive in this matrix. But even the ones who were paying the big dollar bills, they were still being trained to work for somebody else. They didn't want to teach you that you don't have to work with your hands. You don't have to get a 9-to-5 job. All you got to do is think about what you want and you manifest that shit. Many of them know this. That's why they have secret societies. Think about this for a second. Why do you need a secret society? What's the secret? So, in school, what else do they have? Food that they are feeding you that is not really food. There's chemicals in those foods. Processed food is not food. Processed vegetables in a can is not real food. Real food comes from a garden that you need to go and see for yourself that it's growing up from the ground and you pick it and you eat it. But even fruits and vegetables today are sprayed with chemicals and pesticides because they want to say, we don't want the food to go bad. Food was never supposed to be taken from a tree or the ground, sprayed, processed, packaged, shipped to a grocery store, and sitting on a shelf for weeks. It was never supposed to be that way. That's why farmers don't make money nowadays. That's why our farmers, our original people, their farms got taken away. The original way of living was if you were a farmer, you made money off your land because people came to you. We used to go to our own farmers and say, if I want fresh fruit, I will pay you. Circulating the black dollars, like I said. I'll take my black dollar and I'll go to this black supermarket and I'll pay this black supermarket to keep them in power. So as they get paid, whenever they need to spend money, if they come to somebody who needs services from us, whether we're doctors, whether we're lawyers, whether we're practitioners, whether we're architects, that's how you keep it circulating amongst it. So to go back to the idea of school, what else do they have? In school, there is a bell. You get an hour in class cramming information that you're not even going to use later on into the future. Brainwashing. You get information crammed into your mind. You get information crammed into your mind that serves you no justice for an hour. You got to stress over trying to learn all this bullshit that does not serve you. And then when a bell goes off, you get up, you put your books together in your bags, and you go into the next concrete classroom, and you're being taught by a witch or a warlock. Yes, teachers are witches and warlocks. See, the veil has been lifted. We've been tricked. We've been played. We are the supermen and the superwomen that they feared. Because the only way that they can control us was to brainwash us. Because if they did not brainwash us, they knew that we were going to take this system over. You ever notice how in schools, They keep changing shit up. That's why they keep, that's why they need to get control of the system, which is children. Because when we come into this universal planet, this universal playing field, which is originally our realm, we were the gods, we were the goddesses, we were the magical beings. I mean, we still are, but we just forgot who we are. The veil is being lifted to where now you are going to start to realize the truth. So because they couldn't stop us coming into this realm, because we never die, your avatar can die, but your energy regenerates and you come back into this motherfucker. They couldn't stop us coming back. So they had to inject us during birth. They had to start brainwashing us. So again, you think that you're human. You're not. There's a different classification between the two. There's a bunch of alien beings running around. Many of you know, you felt within yourself that you were a being that did not belong here. You were out of this world. Exactly, Star of David. This is the age of truth. Well, we're leaving the Pisces age and we're slowly rolling around into the age of Aquarius, which is the water bearer. That's why you see so many rivers and floods. All this shit is about to be washed away. They're just not telling you the truth. The last remaining place that really needs to be overturned is America. And America really is Kemet, Egypt. This is the real so-called Africa that they didn't want to tell you about. This is the so-called Wakanda that they didn't want to tell you about. Again, we never came from another place in a ship packed like sardines. People don't think about this. Do you really think that we would allow somebody to come over into our land if, let's say, we did come from Africa? Do you really think that we would allow somebody to come over and capture, let's say, 100,000 of our people in chains and put us on a boat? You could barely go into a ghetto neighborhood and take that shit over without getting your ass beat. So what makes you think, again, this is brainwashing, what makes you think that they packed us like sardines in a big ass boat and we didn't fight back? Or what makes you think, if you, let's take it a step further. A plane ride from America over to Africa takes about more than 10 hours. So if a plane that's going about 500-700 miles an hour takes 10 hours or 13 hours or however much it is, what the fuck makes you think that a boat from back in the day where they had people who was rowing, no motors, no nothing, gathered a whole bunch of people up and they were able to bring us all the way over here? You need food, you need supplies, you need to feed everybody. That shit takes about 3 to 4 months. It's not possible. And then another thing that doesn't make sense is people don't take the time to think about this. When they took so-called America over, where did all the people go? When you take a land over, you don't go into another land to repopulate this one. When they stepped foot onto this original land that was beautiful, this was the milk and honey land. If you notice, if so-called Africa is so rich and pure like they lie about, why are Africans coming over here to resupply and then take their shit back that way? Why are so-called Asians coming here to resupply and then take their shit back? Notice everybody comes to America to grab everything and then they go back to their country. To me, that sounds like this is the land of milk and honey that they didn't want to tell y'all about. Again, the only reason our people act the way that they do today is because of television and film. We mimic people. When you, excuse me, Here's an example of mimicking. Remember when Kevin Hart came out with his "All right, all right, all right," and everybody started saying that shit? That's called mimicking. That's called brainwashing. That's called a bunch of clones running around doing what he says. Most people would consider it funny. No, it's just funny, so we're just repeating it. No, the sick joke is that you are brainwashed by these celebrities. Let's take it a step further. Remember when Nicki Minaj first came out and we had a bunch of girls who dressed themselves up to look like Nicki Minaj? That's called brainwashing. They teach you to be like everybody else. They want you to be like these celebrities because these celebrities are paid cash cows to think and act stupid like, what is that girl's name? That rapper who became famous from being stupid. What is the girl? She's Puerto Rican and she sticks her tongue out. Not even bright. Cardi B. Cardi B is an idiotic fool. And everybody's going around sticking their tongue out trying to act and sound like Cardi B. That's called mimicking. They put these idiotic celebrities on TV and show us. They show our children TV. That's why I was like, don't let your kids watch TV. Now, I'm not worried about it today because all that shit is already over with. They're just keeping the, there's people who are here who is keeping the system alive. So that's why everything is still happening the way that it is, because they're still keeping the system going by the people who are asleep. They're the ones who are still keeping the system going by watching TV, by manifesting bullshit. That's why many of them are going to have to die off, because in order for us to get into the new earth, the old has to die. And I mean completely perish. Now, there's no such thing as death, so you can't really, your spirit cannot die, but your avatar is. Many of our parents, many of our grandparents, everybody who took that so-called vaccine, people who decided to voluntarily take that were no longer will be service to this system. That's really what the trick was. So don't trip over people who take the so-called vaccine. They voluntarily took that shit. They already had it written in their soul contract that they were going to take the soul, that take that shit, because their energy will not be able to survive in this new upcoming new earth, the age of Aquarius, which is the age of truth, like I said, where again, people who are witches are starting to reveal themselves. They never left. People who are warlocks are starting to reveal themselves. People who are alchemists are starting to reveal themselves. The true gods and goddesses, the teachers, the practitioners, the original beings, the powerful ones, the super friends, people who had abilities are now starting to show themselves again. We never left. We were just brainwashed into believing that we were somebody who we are not. That's why you see so many people shifting back. That's why, for example, you see me dressed the way that I do. These crystals that I have around my neck, I'm an original shaman. My past lives, I was a shaman. I was a warlock, a teacher. I got all types of superpowers and shit that I'm not even going to go through naming. But I've done this shit. Many of you have done this over and over and over and over again, but you just don't remember it. Because when at birth, you were brainwashed into thinking that you've never been here before. But if you've never been here before, how do you have all these skills and talents that you can do today? If you were never here before, you wouldn't know, you wouldn't have a favorite color. You wouldn't dress the way that you do. You wouldn't have certain gifts and talents. The veil has been lifted to where now, like I said, everything is being revealed. The truth is coming out about who's in control, who's in power, which demons and demonic forces have been here siphoning off our energies. So don't be surprised if friends and family and other people that you thought were your friends and family all of a sudden start to die off, or start to shed their skin, or start to reveal who they really and truly are. That's the veil that's being lifted. So again, going back into manifestation, they are showing you more and more bullshit because they need you to manifest your reality. They have, in order for your reality to be taken over, you're not thinking for yourselves. If you don't have control of your mind, if you don't have control of your thoughts, if you don't have control of your emotions, if you don't have control of yourself, you are being controlled by something else. Because what I always explain to everybody about the whole mindset of the being your higher self is in your head. That God that you pray to is in your head. You are the one making the wish upon a star for it to have a better life. When you get down on your hands and knees, if you still do that and you decide to pray to your so-called God, the truth is you're praying to your own self. You're putting that energy out there that you want something, and therefore you're manifesting your own shit. But they taught you that it's somebody else giving you these things when it's not, it's you. You say the word God, and they put into your mental image that God is a man, God is a he, God has white flowing hair, God has a beard, God is above you, granting you wishes. No, you are the God that is above the clouds. That's your higher self. You're asking your higher self to grant your wishes, to manifest your reality here in this universal playing field. So we're already in heaven and hell. You're in heaven when you have control of your mind because you are manifesting your own truth. You're in hell in your mind when your life is off track because you're the one thinking these negative thoughts, not anybody else. You can't blame nobody but yourself. That's the truth that a lot of people aren't ready for. And if you are not ready for it, you will not make it in this new earth. Because the year 2020 was the year to where you had to peel back onions, layers of yourself. Who you were taught to be is not who you originally are. Until you get control of your mindset, until you do your shadow work. And shadow work consists of finding out the negative aspects about you that you've been hiding from and correcting that shit. If you don't know what shadow work is, I suggest you start. Because the only way that you're going to manifest your hell, your heaven, and get out of this hell is by finding out what are you running from in your life. When you figure out what you're running from in your life, that's when your life will become the greatest of all time. Because you are creating this shit. You created the circumstances. You chose the people that you decided to date. You chose the circumstances that you decided to be in. You chose this life before you came here. So don't trip when things go bad. It's you chose this, your higher self. You, before you came into this avatar body, chose this life. So you could learn a lesson. And when you learn that lesson and you awaken yourself, all this bullshit that you went through when you were in your hell, when you went through that stuff and you learned your lesson, now you can manifest your reality, which is your heaven. So many people are running around here upset, pissed off. Nobody, people for people forgot what this was. People forgot what this was. This is a magical place. You think Disney just shows you magic for no reason. You think cartoons are fake? They're real. That's us. That's you. Whatever you relate to. If you feel, if you love Sailor Moon, then you are a Sailor Moon individual. That's why you love it. If you love Super Friends, you are one of those Super Friends. If you identify with any of these characters, that's who you were before your great fall. Think about it for a second. How do you know, or why do you like these characters? There's a reason you like the Green Lantern, or Superman, or Supergirl, or Batman, or Superman, or whoever it is. The rabbit hole is deep, Star of David. It's too deep. I'm only 3 years into my awakening and I'm still falling. It's a process, but everybody has to choose to go down that rabbit hole. And people, the problem is too many people are afraid to go down that rabbit hole because they're fearful. And the crazy thing is people don't realize the fear that you fear is yourself. When I started my spiritual journey, before I knew about third eye, before I knew about manifestations, before I knew about how to access my mind, I was fearful myself. I didn't know what the fuck was going on. Because again, we're shown fear. What does everybody watch today on television? When you turn on Netflix, why do we get so used to watching death on TV and destruction? Why did we get so used to playing violent video games? Why are we so used to just destruction, period? But we're not used to love. We're magical, loving beings. That's the next thing I want to talk about. They don't want us. You know what their biggest fear is? The entities that have that got control of us, because yeah, we were taken over by artificial intelligence. That's why you see, notice how all of a sudden electronic phones came out of nowhere. Smartphones came out of nowhere. Televisions came out of nowhere. Flat screen TVs. Notice how technology jumped the fuck up quickly. That's because we were taken over, but people didn't realize it because we were brainwashed into believing that this is technology that's good for us. Now, technology in itself is not bad. It's who's controlling the technology. That's why they show you the films. Men in Black, that shit is real. If it was fake, they wouldn't have all that information. It's not a fake ass. There's no way they would have labeled all those so-called aliens or had the vehicles that they showed you. They show you this shit because they're showing you to your face what's really true. But they have to lie and say that it's not, and it's a movie. This low-level technology that we're dealing today, cell phones, Blu-ray disc, we been had flying cars. We invented that shit. We been had flying vehicles, flying cars. We used to be able to fly hoverboards. All that shit was originally created by us. You know how they show on Superman Brainiac, the artificial intelligence that took over the planet, that took over Superman? And notice he had the three dots. Brainiac has the three dots on his head to represent the pyramid. That's all true. So we got so in tune with this technology that we've forgotten who we were. We put our God likelihoods down for a cell phone that has everything you supposedly need on it. Let me show y'all something that many don't recognize. This is one of my phones, right? And on the back of my phone, I have this is called a EMF. This basically prevents the radiation and the negative energy from attacking my body. That's why I have one of these. So I suggest if you don't have these things, you need to find them. You can get them for like $10 on Etsy. The cell phone with the naked eye cannot see this infrared. Hold on, let me see something. Where is it? Hold on a second. Let me show y'all. Because there's a low red light that beeps. That it might not be on this one. Yeah, it might not be on this one. I'm gonna have to show you my other one. But there's a little red light, which is it's a little red light that you can't see with your naked eye. That's basically an infrared that beams to your third eye. That's a laser beam that's beaming to your third eye. That's why you can't stop looking at your phone. I won't show you, but just know that it's there. Those little dots that's at the very top of your phone where your camera is, there's a little light, an infrared light that's constantly flashing. That's the thing that's keeping your eyes and attention lasered onto your phone so you can't put your phone down. It's basically fucking with your third eye. So, these artificial beings that are not real, that are used to trick us, the biggest fear is not an individual, is not one of us with a gun. Guns are primitive. We don't need guns because we have the power of our mind. When you have control of your reality, you don't need a gun. You have a gun because you fear something. You fear yourself. Fear is an illusion. So people who go around and they say, well, I want to have a gun for protection. One, guns are primitives. When you buy a gun, you're fearing something. When you're fearing something, you're creating monsters in your reality. You're creating people who are coming after you with a gun. So if you buy a gun in your house because you're afraid that somebody's going to burglarize and enter, you're creating that burglar to come into your house one day. You're creating that break-in to happen. Again, how do I know this? They show you on TV. They fear-monger you. They show you death and destruction constantly. That's why you want a gun, because you fear shit you saw on TV. We are the you manifest shit that you see. Think about it. Again, how many Netflix movies do you see where everybody's getting their head blown off? Where limbs are being destroyed, where guns, bombs, destruction. All we see is negative shit on TV. Now, if you take that image and you broadcast it to millions of people around the world, that's millions of individuals being brainwashed to see death and destruction, and they manifest that shit into their reality. That's why you see all this destruction going on, if you do, in your world. Everybody's literally running around being fearful. That movie Bird Box, that's what that's about. A bunch of people running around fearing shit that they don't realize. Notice, nothing was going on in that reality. But each individual person had their own demons they were facing. That's why many people, they was like, close your eyes. Because if you open up your eyes, you're playing your own hell right in front of you. That's what the movie Bird Box was about. That's why they had people covering their eyes, because they fear their own reality. So again, if you got a gun, ask yourself, why do you need the gun? Ask yourself, why do you fear anything? You are a cosmic being. You don't need no motherfucking gun to protect shit, because you're the one creating the demons in the closet. I've never had to have a gun in my life. Matter of fact, nobody's ever tried to fight me in this lifetime, because I've always been protected. My mindset was always more advanced than majority of people. And people who did try to fuck with me, entities that did try to fuck with me, my ancestors and my spirit guides, I always had protection. My higher self, my imagination, anytime there were times where people who tried to fight me, which was very little, or anybody who tried to fuck with me in my reality, my higher self, my imagination had backup to where I never had to fight my own battles, because anytime somebody tried me, my spirit guides and my ancestors and the powers that be that were protected by me came and did the dirty work for me. I got plenty of stories where people who ever tried me got fucked up and I didn't have to do shit because they touched the wrong one. That's how powerful every single one of you are, but you don't realize it. That's why I'm here teaching every single one of you to get out of this fear mongering, because you're the one creating the hell in your reality. Ain't nobody else doing that shit but you. Find out what you fear and stop fearing it, and your reality will become beautiful. So let me go back to talking about, the ability to love and why love is such a powerful thing that they don't want us to do. You know how when a baby is first born in the womb, in the mother's womb, which FYI, that's what this represents. The Ankh is the original symbol of life, because what does this look like? This is the womb. This is the portal. This is the vagina. The only way you make it into this reality is by coming through the portal of the vagina. Masculine energy, feminine energy. That's what the Ankh symbolizes. So do your research. That's why the Ankh is so powerful. That's why it means the symbol of life. So love is all you need, simply because love is energy. Love is energy. The heart, when a baby is born, what's the first thing that grows on a baby? The first thing that causes, before the brain gets developed. Anybody who's ever looked at a child grow, the first thing that grows heavy and big is the heart. Notice the heart doesn't need help pumping. That's the Tony Stark infinite chest plate. The heart works on its own. Love, the energy of love is so powerful. That's why they wanted to take it away from our people. Because when we love each other, the energy of love, because again, love is energy. It ain't just a word. Notice when you love somebody, or you've ever been in love with somebody, what's the first thing you feel? Butterflies in your stomach, right? Them ain't butterflies, that's energy. That's your solar plexus energizing itself from the heart chakra. When you really fall in love with somebody, you get blissful feelings. You get on top of the world. If you've ever been in love before, you know what I'm talking about. Even if you just liked somebody, y'all know what I'm talking about. When you like a boy or a girl, when you were kids, and your energy is really feeling them, you get these feelings bubbling up inside of your system. And that's your avatar's energy being, letting you know that things are amazing. That's your energy brewing. That's the energy of love. We used to love each other. We used to uplift each other by thought, words, and intentions. So if you go into a community where people have their mindsets together, where people are not calling each other bitch-ass niggas and hoes and sluts, and everybody's not fighting, that is a dangerous neighborhood, simply because they are unified. A neighborhood ain't big and bad when you got a bunch of dumbasses running around sagging their pants. And I've been telling people this so many different times. If you sag your pants, please stop. That means you a bitch. And I'm not saying that to get on you. I mean, literally, pants hanging down was generated back in when there were so-called slavery days. That was the masters. That was letting people know that you're somebody's bitch. Your pants are hanging off your ass because it means that's easy access when they want to fuck you. That's why these celebrities sag their pants. They let you know that they already somebody's bitch, being fucked by the industry. Again, why do you need to sag your pants? That's the stupidest shit ever. I've told people this 1,000 times and they was like, man, that's my swag. Okay, go ahead and be somebody's bitch. Continue that swag of having pants hang off your ass. Knowledge is power. They showed you, the celebrities sagged their pants and everybody followed suit. Celebrities started calling everybody bitches and hoes and sluts. It all started with the music industry. NWA, talking about fuck the police. It's two sides to that coin. One, yes, it is fuck the police, but again, you're putting your energy where? To hate the police. And when you put your energy to hate the police, do you know what you're doing? You're giving your hatred towards entities that feed off of that hate. Instead of saying fuck the police, how about you not even worry about the police and they'll disappear? The police only fuck with you in your neighborhood because many of you keep talking about the shit. Racism only exists when you keep talking about the shit. Stop talking about stuff that don't serve your neighborhood. Stop talking about shit that don't serve you. Notice whenever we walk around, none of us acknowledge each other anymore. Nobody does. Everybody walks around afraid to say, how you doing, God? How you doing, goddess? You're looking beautiful today. You're looking respectful today. Do you need a hand? Do you need assistance? We got so used to walking around talking shit to each other. And again, when you talk shit to one another, what are you doing? You are casting spells on your brothers and sisters. The word spells, remember when they did spelling bees when you were a child? Spelling or sounding a word out, the English language is not our original language. It's a spell casting language. When we are first brought into this world, we already have a universal language. Baby talk isn't stupidity talk. Baby talk is actually the ancient language. That's why babies can talk to each other and they understand each other. They're not stupid. They're just little beings brought into this world before they were brainwashed by our so-called parents. And if many of you have kids and you don't know what I'm talking about, you brainwashed your children as well. Because you taught them everything that the Matrix taught you, and that's how the bloodline continues. Grandparents taught your parents taught you, and you teach your kids. That's how the cycle continues. So whatever it is that the Matrix taught you, that is what is going on constantly in the bloodline. You're being taught wrong shit. And the generational curse keeps continuing. That's why we are shifting out of the age of Pisces. And we are shifting into a new age of Aquarius, which is no more lies. No more bullshit, no more schools. That's why the schools closed down. People don't realize this, but the coronavirus was actually, first of all, corona means crown. Look it up. Corona is the sun. So that's the truth and the lie at the same time. They have to call it a virus because exactly that's what it is. The sun is emitting a virus in this matrix in order to kill off what shouldn't be here. That's the trick to the trade that many of you can't get. So when they say coronavirus, they're not lying to you. They're actually telling you the fucking truth. We have, the matrix does not belong here. These concrete buildings, these antennas, these artificial beings that took our shit over, are they're the ones who don't belong here. So the sun admitted a virus, which they changed the sun changed its course. The energy has changed. The energy of the planet has changed. The frequency has heightened. And let me break something else down to you. If this system, think about, again, this is a simulated reality we're living in. This is the Matrix. The Matrix has been tainted. Our world has been tainted. This originally was supposed to be a paradise, but it got taken over. Now it's tainted. I am considered a virus to this system because I'm coming here fucking it up so that our people are not asleep anymore and they are being awakened. That's what many of you are. You are the coronavirus fucking up this system. When you put a virus into a computer, it fucks it up. Corona virus. It ain't got nothing to do with sickness. It ain't got nothing to do with health. It ain't got none of that shit. They had to teach every single one of you to cover your face so that you didn't breathe in this new energy that comes from the planet Nibiru. Yes, Planet X and Planet Nibiru exist. There are beings that's been above us. There are spaceships that's been up in the air. They're not called clouds. Those are cloaked ships. That's why they've been spraying the skies constantly, because the artificial beings that can't take the sun and the energy, they have to keep spraying the skies because they want to continuously live for as long as they can before the great fall happens. Once all this shit falls and they can't spray the skies no more, you're about to start seeing a bunch of people die off. The people that die off don't belong here. That's truth. It ain't got shit to do with racism. It ain't got shit to do. It's again, everybody has been lied to. Not to mention, if you think about it, how is it considered racist when the planet is killing what doesn't belong here? When the sun is killing what doesn't belong here, that means that the universe has made its decision to say enough is enough. It ain't got shit to do with telling somebody, so you mean to tell me that I don't belong here? Yes. The universe is telling you you don't belong here because, again, the natural beings that can take the sun, because I come from the sun. That's why my name is Aaron Abinor. I'm the son of the green light. I come from the sun tribe. That's why my energy be heavy as fuck. Many of you radiate the same amount of energy from the sun. That's why a lot of people can't be around you. That's why some of the people try to come around you, because they want to siphon off your fucking kinetic energy. So welcome to the age of truth. I'm the person. I don't filter anything out for anybody. I don't have time for it. The universe has made its decision. Mother Kai is tired of being fucked. She's tired of being pumped with these pumps that are sucking the blood. Oil, black goo that comes from the earth is blood from our mother. She's tired of being sucked dry. That's why she's killing these entities off that don't belong here. She's tired of the air being polluted. She's tired of her original children that come from the ground. We're the protectors. We're supposed to be the protectors. That's why many of us, like I said, they're showing these superhero movies because they're telling you the truth. The Justice League, the Guardians of the Galaxies have returned. Many of you are these guardians, just like me. Mother is tired of being fucked over. A jewel, Star of David. Jews, original Jews, are us. That's why there's a difference between Jews and Jewish. Ish means you ain't really a Jew. The original Jews, let me spit some more knowledge to you that people didn't want to tell you. The reason they hate Hitler so much is because Hitler was actually killing off the beings that did not belong here. But they had to train and teach you that, oh, Hitler committed genocide. No, Hitler actually knew who the original Jews were, which was us. Hitler didn't hate us. And not to mention, Hitler wasn't even really white. He wasn't that complexion. And the Nazi symbol is not negative. That's the swastika. The swastika is a symbol of peace and prosperity. Again, in school, what did they have to teach you? Hitler did this and committed genocide. Hitler is an evil person. It's always reverse. Who they teach you to hate are the ones who actually were the ones who did right. But again, like I said, you got too many people that would listen to what I say and say that I'm a racist when they don't do their own fucking research. The original Jews, you're looking at one of them. You're looking at a cosmic being. So Hitler wasn't doing nothing but doing a favor for everybody. Because again, there are artificial beings that don't belong here. If you don't belong here, how is it racist or how is it negative for somebody to tell the truth? Again, this is the age of Aquarius. Don't nobody want to hear the truth because they're too busy sucking on mama's titty, being brainwashed. Check your goddamn truth and check your goddamn facts before you start popping off at the mouth about what's right and what's wrong. Trust me, I got plenty of people who agree with me. I even got beings that know they're artificial that tell me they know that I'm 100% correct. Because they don't even like the system that they're going on because they got fucked up themselves. Not only did the system fuck us up, but they fucked up their own people too. Brainwashing them, making them think that they were the original ones here when they're really not. So again, if you're one of the ones watching this and this is hurting your feelings, get over it. Blame your forefathers who lied to you about the original people of this planet. The original people of this land. The shit was taken from us and given to the wrong people. And all this bullshit has been going on for too long. We're not doing this shit no more. We're taking back what was ours. This land was ours. Not made for you and made for me. And again, I don't want to hear shit about sharing because again, like I said, if I decide, oh, I want to share this land with you, why would I share my land with beings that killed off my entire generation? Why would I do that? That's why I got activated. I'm not here to make amends. I'm here to bring death and destruction to those who don't belong. That's my job. And even if I don't do it, like I said, the universe already made its decision. The sun is already fucking up those who don't belong here. The energy mother is already fucking up beings that don't belong here. So again, you ain't even got to worry about me because it's doing it on its own. As we raise our energies, do you know what global warming is code word for? Global warming is code word for these niggas are waking up. The earth is heating up because it's a sun. This planet is originally a sun. That's why, notice the energy comes. We have a sun in the center of the planet. That's why the ground, the heat comes from the top and the bottom. We got a sun in the center, and we got two or three suns that rotate around. It was never day. Nighttime doesn't exist. We have an artificial barrier around us that cuts the lights off, that makes it dark. That moon is not real. It's artificial. They told you this in Star Wars. That's no moon. It's a space station. The shit don't even rotate. The shit stays on one particular axis. The shit has a light that goes half and half. So what's going on is global warming is code word for these niggas is waking up. And let me drop another code for you for people who don't like, why do you keep saying niggas? Because I'm not talking about N-I-G-G-E-R. I'm talking about N-E-G-A-S. Niggas is nagas, which means kings and queens, the original beings. So they've been calling us by our names a long time ago, but we all got mad. Don't call me a nigga. They know who we are. They've been knew who we are. We're the gods of this motherfucker. Do you remember Space Jam? The first one? Remember when Michael Jordan made a deal with the Monstars? And he was like, either play this game. And they were like, if I win, you give my friends their powers back. Y'all didn't peep that, did you? Go back and look at Space Jam. The Monstars came, kidnapped the basketball players, and stole their abilities for themselves and made these beings stupid as fuck. And Michael Jordan had to go and play the Monstars, and he made a deal with the entity. The entity said, I'll make a deal with you. If I win, you leave this motherfucker and you give my friends their powers back. And then the dude said, well, what if we win? He said, if you win, you get me. And then what did he say? You're going to be our star attraction. You're going to sign autographs all day long and you're going to play one-on-one with the paying customers and you'll always lose. Who watches the basketball games? Majority of the time, who owns the basketball teams? Who owns the basketball players, the NFL players? Who owns the rights to the music that we are playing? So as you can see, there's truth all around you. You just don't know how to pay attention to it. Go back and look at Space Jam with your third eye. Michael Jordan could fly because originally he can fly. That's why we can jump higher. That's why we can move faster. That's why our genius is unmatched. They had to level the playing field by getting rid of us, by killing us off and getting rid of our memories. We are every time you kill us off and you bring us and we're brought back, you bring your old memories back with you. That's why they need to erase your mind so you think it's your first time being here. That's why they couldn't keep the playing field level, because they knew that from birth, we already magical in this motherfucker. It's the artificial beings that don't know shit, because they have to wait until we drop something before we do it. We created rock and roll first, and then they came back and stole that shit. Fuck up Elvis Presley. He was an entity anyway. He was a draconian motherfucker. There's proof. You can go back and look. You can look that shit up. Chuck Berry was the one who originated that shit before Elvis Presley. Same thing with blues, jazz, rock and roll. Country, we originated that shit. We did it first, and then it was stripped from us, and then they brought their people in to mimic what the fuck is going on. That's why they always want to be around us. They got to wait to see what we create. And again, get out your ass if you're thinking I'm being racist. I'm telling you goddamn facts that most of these other vibrational beings won't tell you. And again, yep, Star of David, Charlie Pride. The Wright brothers didn't invent goddamn automobile. The Wright brothers didn't invent aircrafts. We've been had spaceships. Fuck you mean?
The automobile wasn't created by Henry Ford. We been had flying spaceships before this shit. If you go and look at the Egyptian walls, you see spaceships on that shit. That was us. We originated this shit. We're the ones. Nikola Tesla, that was a brother as well. Again, they need to show you false beings so you think you are nothing but a slave. That's why they can't show you the truth. But if you've been, if let me tell y'all a hint. If y'all been paying attention to the times, notice who's coming back. Notice if you've been paying attention to these TV shows, all the black stars are coming back into power. All the action movies are now showing us back on TV because, again, their time been up. But there are entities, there are still people who are stuck in this matrix still believing the artificial race is on top when they're not. So again, I don't have a reason to be so-called racist. Racism is a goddamn low-level word that they created, so you shut the fuck up and you didn't speak your truth. You can't tell somebody they're racist when you originally came into this motherfucker and took from us first. We are now getting everything back that was owed to us. Fuck a 40 acres and a mule. We own all this shit. This is our realm, and we are the magical beings. Do you remember the movie Kazam with Shaquille O'Neal? Him being a genie, granting wishes to a little white boy? That's true. The new Aladdin that just came out. Who was the genie? Will Smith, right? He was blue, right? That's true. We used to be blue, yellow, green, purple. We were all the colors of the rainbow. We were the rainbow children. The only reason we're this color now is because they introduced all types of bullshit into the atmosphere that turned us this color. Some of you, when you were born, you had green birthmarks on you. Some of you still have birthmarks on you that are green. That was your original color. Congratulations, you were green. So, the return is here. So, stop worrying about fear. Stop worrying about death. Stop worrying about destruction. I'm telling you, the moment you delete that shit out of you reprogram your mind. Do you wonder why they can't fuck with me? It's because I have control of my mind again. The best that they can do is try to scare me. Your mama said you got a green booty, then guess what? You used to be green. Congratulations. Who else was green? Osiris. Y'all ever realize whenever we get cut, your skin automatically heals itself? Y'all ain't never think about that? Where you think they got Wolverine from? Where you think they got claws from? You ever not cut your nails? And you accidentally scratch yourself? Where do you think they got claws from? We have plant DNA because we are the plants. What's growing out of my head? What's growing out of my head? Aren't these roots? Aren't these roots growing out of my head? Don't I need to drink water in order to survive? If I don't drink water, what happens? I get dehydrated. What else gets dehydrated when it doesn't get water? Plants. What else dies when it doesn't get sunlight? Plants. Why don't many of you have energy today? Because your ass ain't getting no sunlight. Why do you think they got rid of PE? Because they knew these kids were way too powerful to be playing outside. When you go and you play outside in the sun, you are heating up the planet too much. They couldn't take that energy no more. Well, I'm psychic as well. So if many of you are like, yo, you saying what I'm saying? Well, two things. One, I'm psychic. Two, we're on the same frequency. I explained that the other night. Many of you who have awakened yourselves, you're on the same frequency, like a radio broadcast, like a telephone. Hey, bro, what channel are you on? I'm on 144 channel. All right, let me turn to it. Click, 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 click. Okay, can you hear me? Yeah, I can hear you now. We're all on the same frequency. When you go in nature, 432 hertz frequency is the energy of the planet. We're all going back to that frequency. That's why many of us can universally tell it. We're all going back to telepathy. I'm gonna prove to many of you how telepathy works. You use telepathy every single day and you don't even realize it. Telepathy works like this. You ever notice right before you got a phone call from somebody, they popped into your head, pick up the phone, yo, I was just thinking about you. That's called telepathy. Randomly, when you get random thoughts out of nowhere, that's called you're connecting to the ether. That's the Wi-Fi signal. When you grow your hair out, like I've done, like so, this is why, again, they needed you to hate yourself. They needed you to hate your hair. They needed you to cut all your hair off because universally, this is your wisdom and your knowledge. In the air around us is energy. There's energy all around us in the fucking air. Earth, wind, and fire is everywhere. When you grow your hair out, your hair is 9 ether. It's connecting and trapping energy into this, which is going into your mind, which is increasing your crown chakra. That's why we get universal knowledge instantly. That's why if you notice, I know y'all can be like, yo, you talk for like hours and hours and hours. And where are you getting all this knowledge from? From the ether. We were never supposed to cut our hair, people. But what did they give you? Barbershops and shit. Fresh ass fades. Now, me personally, I'm a warrior. So that's why I haven't gotten a haircut in a while. But I always keep my sides trimmed because that's a warrior status. Oh, y'all didn't see? Y'all, I didn't show y'all. For many of you, let me show y'all. Let me bring you over to my altar real quick. And by the way, if many of you don't have an altar, I suggest you get one. I'm connected with my past life. That's me. Many of you have this inside of you, by the way. That sword is not for show. That's my shit from a past life. All this is my past life shit. Yep, crystals, all this. Mm-hmm. This is all me. The reason I got candles lit is simply because when you light a candle and you got incense burning and you have on your altar earth, wind, and fire, you're calling forth the elements of the cosmos. That's why I have that stuff there. I'm a dragon. I used to be a dragon in my past life. Yes, I used to be. I have the bloodline. I come from the bloodline of Anubis, the bloodline of Thoth. I'm many things. So when you get to know yourself, and just before I move on, if you don't have an altar and you don't know why you should have one, ask me and I'll talk about it. If you don't know, ask me and I'll explain why you need an altar. But the universal language of love, the universal language is love. When you love yourself and you love energy and you love nature and you go within nature, you get connected all over again. Think about this for a second. Do you go outside or do you stay your ass or do you stay your ass inside using Wi-Fi signals? And by the way, Wi-Fi signals taints the energy in the air. That's why you can't think. That's why you can't remember shit. Your cell phone gives off an energy. Cell phone towers. Oh, them bitches are radio broadcast. That's fucking everybody up. They about to come down as well. Real kings never die. You know about your past life. You just don't realize it. Step one. You need to tell yourself that you remember who you are and it'll happen. It's as simple as that. I'm going to give y'all some hints. Stop saying the word, and I'm not saying this about you, I'm just giving examples because there's people who do this. Stop saying the word can't, won't, and don't put I in front of it. Don't ever say I can't. Don't ever say I won't. Because what you're doing is your thoughts and your words and your vibrations are controlling your mind. So you know what I'm talking about. So what I want you to do is in your meditation, tell yourself, repeat it daily. Say to yourself, I remember my past life. Or ask yourself in meditation, close your eyes, get calm, get peaceful, get centered, and just tell and ask yourself, your higher self, dear higher self, show me who I am. Show me my past lives. And it may not happen instantly because if you're not used to it, you see it. Trust me, you see it every single day, but you just don't, most people don't know how to pay attention to it. You want to know how you can figure out easily who you were in your past life? Look at who you are today. For example, I have a sword on my altar. Before I knew who I was, as a kid, I used to love ninja stuff. I used to love samurai stuff. I used to love anything that was considered Japanese. Because, by the way, I'm not black. No. That's why I wear what I wear. I always had a style for this because that's a hint of who I was in one of my past lives. So all you got to do is look at yourself. What do you like? How do you dress? What do you really like deep down inside? You need to do a chart of yourself. Like this. This is you. What do you like? Me, I like ninjas, which relates to swords, which relates to, I like melee weapons, ninjas. I also like the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. That's also a hint because that's a ninja. What else do you like? Well, I like artwork. I'm good at poetry. You need to do this. And this is how you figure out who you were in all of your past lives. Decipher yourself. Appreciate it, Star David. I give that energy right back to you. Your style is beautiful and honest just as well. This is what we need to start doing with one another. Uplift each other. Again, we so used to talking shit to each other. There you go. Real kings never die. If you like Mortal Kombat, that means that you were a warrior. Simple as that. You like it for a reason. You don't just like something because you like it. I like the color blue because I love communication. And I'm also connected with the energy of Thoth. Thoth is actually my father. My spiritual father, yes. That's why I wear these colors, because I'm a communicator. So you like colors for a reason. You like green for a reason. You like orange for a reason. You like yellow for a reason. So whatever characters you like in Mortal Kombat that you relate to, most likely that was you. They're talking about you. All these characters, that these video games are playing, do you know what they're doing? They're telling that that's us, but they got to put it in video game and movie format. That's us. So that's another hint. Find out everything that you like. If you like Thor, if you relate to Thor, then most likely you were Thor in another lifetime. That was a character. This is a simulated reality, and every single one of you are players. You keep changing characters every time you pass on and you go into another level. And also, your names are hints too. For instance, my birth name is called Aaron. Aaron in the Bible is a prophet. I'm a prophet. Your names have meaning. That's why I mentioned, not only do you need to do that chart about yourself, and when I say write down everything you like, I'm talking about down to the T. I fucks with Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I fuck with Power Rangers. I fucks with T'Challa from Black Panther. Killmonger, that's a story about me, because I'm from Oakland. Our hair, many of you need to realize this is a simulated reality. So a lot of these stories that you relate to, they're talking about you. So the story of Killmonger is about me, because I'm actually a sleeper agent as well. I'm one of those agents that they needed to keep sleep because I have a lot of assassin. I was an assassin in my past life too. I was one of those ones that you didn't fuck with. That's why I wasn't able to fight in this lifetime. I never fought anybody before because I know how to end somebody instantly. So my rage is beyond. So in this lifetime, I had to be tainted and I had to be calm. That's why I always stay calm, because nobody's ever seen my original side. So if you're watching this and you want to know your past life, decipher yourself. Don't look at the side of you that you show everybody. Look at the side of you that you know deep down inside that you love. If you love ballet, that means you were a dancer. It ain't no bitch move. Everything has purpose and meaning. I'm a dancer. I'm good at fucking ballet. That means I'm swift on my feet. Pay attention to everything. You like it for a reason. That's why I've been telling everybody, the crystals that I sell, the designs that I create, that necklace that y'all saw that I wore the other day, I designed this stuff because crystals help you figure out who you are. That's why I teach people about crystals. So I sell crystal creations. So if anybody interested in crystals, that's what crystals do. Crystals are magical, are actually magic. They help you. There's crystals that help you remember your past lives. There are crystals that help you generate your psychic abilities. There's crystals that help you with your solar plexus. There's crystals that are for menstrual cycles. There's crystals. When I say there's crystals for every fucking thing, there's crystals that actually heal sicknesses. And I'm a code creator too. The energy that I give, because I'm a shaman healer, the energies that I put into my crystal creations actually amplifies everybody's abilities. That's why people buy from me all the time. So go check out my page if you're interested. I'm gonna type it right here. Apparently I can't tag myself, but I'm just going to put this here anyway. That's my crystal page. Yeah, come on over. Now I tell people all the time, because I gotta be real with y'all. My crystals don't come cheap, but again, I don't want anybody. See, this is what I tell people. I don't want anybody to come to my page and be like, oh, that costs too much. Because what it is if you think about something costs too much, then you will always stay broke. That's another hint I'm gonna tell everybody. And I give sessions as well, too. If anybody need help with past lives, figuring out who you are, I give sessions. Because I teach every single one of you not to be broke anymore. I teach you how to get money every single day by your thoughts, words, and thinkings. So I always tell people, it's energy. So the reason my crystals they're not really pricey. But again, I always tell people, most people will come and they'll see the price and they'll be like, well, I don't want to pay that much. But they'll pay $300 for some Jordans. And I'm like, why pay $300 for some shit that ain't going to do nothing for you? When you get something from me, I unlock people. I unlock their abilities to do stuff. So people who buy from me, they get more than they bargain for. So that's why I was like, when y'all come to my page and you see something, don't think about, oh, it's a little bit too pricey, because you're downgrading yourself. I always teach people, when you want something, you don't think that it's too expensive. If you really want it, but you can't get it right now, speak it. Ask the universe. Ask yourself. Write that shit down. I want this and I want such and such and such and such. Thank you, universe. Thank you, higher self. And you're going to attract that shit to you. It's as simple as that. When you want something in this reality, think about it. Think about the funds coming to you and you will literally get paid. That's what I do. That's why I already put it in my head. Yeah, come to my page. I got a whole bunch of crystals and shit. I got to order some more stuff. So even if I don't have it, which most likely I do, I always tell people we can order some shit and then I'll wrap the creations. I might as well show y'all some of my shit now. This is the latest one I did. This one's already sold, but every time I rap, I take the energies of each individual person. And Monty knows what I'm talking about. She took a lesson with me, and she also, shit, Monty, while you on here, I'll show everybody your creation. I just did. I just finished Monty's creation. This is my latest that I finished today. This is Monty's right here. So each crystal is always going to be different, because I don't create the same for everybody. I don't do that. I get downloads, and everybody's piece is going to be different depending on what the crystals tell me. They tell me how they need to be wrapped, and also I read people's energies. So that's why people come to me and I rap a certain way differently, because my wrappings tell differently about people. So this is my latest one. And this is this crystal right here is called the yellow jasper, which is actually a shaman crystal. So Monty, congratulations. You chose this because you're a shaman in your past life. And then the person I created this one for, she's actually a fairy in one of her lifetimes. So this is what this came out to be. She was actually a princess. So she chose these three crystals right here. This one, because my raps start off at, and they're kind of going to go higher, but the necklaces right now start off at 67, but I'm going to be raising them. 67 plus shipping of like $8. So that comes out to like 75. That's for one crystal. Then I got bracelets for 65 for one crystal. And then the rings are 55 for one crystal. And then
if you want more crystals, that just increase in prices. So this one went for $111. Like I said, it all depends. But again, I always tell people, don't look at the idea that it's pricey, because you're going to get the money right back. You just got to have your thoughts, words, and intentions aligned. So not only do you get, this is more than just jewelry. I don't just create jewelry. You actually get codes. I put codes into these things. So when people get crystals from me and they meditate with them or they wear them, I unlock certain chakras and abilities in them that take them to the next level. Same thing with my sessions. That's what I'm here for. These are the tools that I use. I'm also, like I said, from Atlantis. I'm one of the original Atlanteans. I created a lot of technology. Shit, I might as well show y'all my staff too. This shit done went from a teaching session to a what's the name session. So I created, this is the staff I did. My staff started at $150 because I supply the wood, I carve it down, and then I supply the crystals for this. So this one went for about, I did this for $250. So they wanted an Ankh, the number 13. This is the Anubis sigil. So symbols mean everything. And then they have the tiger's eye, the rose quartz crystal cluster, the amethyst crystal, and then the clear quartz. So I do the wood. Real Kings Never Die. My sessions start off at for an hour. I just changed my prices. For an hour, which I drop a lot of gems, an hour is with me is $88. For 30 minutes, it's $44. Yeah, it's $44 for 30 minutes and $88 for an hour. And trust me, it's worth it. So like I said, I teach people, don't worry about none of that shit. So if you want to book a session, just inbox me and we'll pick a time and a place. You drop payment and then we set you up. And because I work from home, so I'm always available. And then I named this one 13th Light. This 13 is a favorite number of mine, so I always give it inscriptions, writings. I activate it, and I put inscriptions on it. So I'm also a carpenter. Yeah, I'm that nigga if you really want to be for real. So that's why people come to me all the time. And this motherfucker powerful. This actually brings the sun out. I tested it. I went outside, and I pointed up at the clouds. And I chanted the words, remove the clouds, remove the clouds and the chemtrails. And that shit fucking disappeared. It was dope as fuck. Okay, so back to the lesson at hand. Yeah, I do Cash App. So you would just inbox me. You said you wanted to learn about past lives, so I already know what you want to do. So yeah, just inbox me. We pick a time and a place that's suitable for you. Pick whether you want 30 minutes or an hour. And I do Cash App, Venmo, PayPal. I do all that shit. I do Zelle. So yeah, I do Cash App. So yeah, just inbox me and then we'll get you set up. And ask Monty. Monty did one session with me, and I broke her the fuck out of that shell. And Monty already on her way, and then she came back and got a crystal from me. So trust me, I'm a one-stop shop. When I teach people shit, I teach them everything. I don't do that little pity-pat petty shit like therapy where you got to come back session after session after session. If people want to come back session after session, yeah, they can. And I'm going to be starting a mentor program to where if people want to train under me, they can do that. I just been kind of slow because it's a lot of shit I got to do. When I got activated, I mean, I have a lot of catching up to do, y'all. Like, I have a mission. I'm going to be traveling to Atlanta next. That's going to be my next stopping ground. So my next mission is I got to go back to my second home, which is Atlanta, a.k.a. Atlantis, because I need to fix a lot of shit down there as well. So that's going to be my next stop. Yeah, it's FaceTime. Or we can do it on here. I usually do it on here. I need to set up a Zoom as well, but yeah, we can do it on whether it's, if you just want to do voice, we could do voice. It's whatever you're comfortable with. If you just want to do voice, you don't want to show your face, that's fine, but I prefer FaceTime. So like I said, I can see what I need to see and I can decipher and all that. But yeah, we can do it on we can do it on here. Or, like I said, well, yeah, just, we'll talk. But yeah, FaceTime. So, and I'm going to be on here more because I know most people saw that I disappeared for a minute. I had to go over to Facebook and do my due diligence there. But Facebook is kind of falling off the map for me. I did all I needed to, so I don't really do Facebook no more. So now I'm coming back over here. So I'm going to be on here dropping a bunch of knowledge and continuous videos and all other stuff. So I'm going to be here now until it's time for me to leave this shit. And then I'm going to go elsewhere. But long story short, I'm going to be, I already have a website, which is, I have all that in my bio, but yeah, that's what I'm going to be. That's what I'm going to do. But yeah, I'll get you right on track. Kings never die. We'll get you straightened out. And like I said, for people who did not pay attention, this app that you guys have been hearing, this frequency app, I know the developer, she's actually from the future. She's an alien as well. I mean, we're all aliens, but she's from the future and I'm working with her. Download this app. Because this is very important. Okay, there we go. My bad, y'all. I accidentally hit the power button. Y'all still here? Okay, let me show y'all something real quick. Oof, thought I lost. Well, I did lose y'all for a second. But this is the app that everybody needs to download. It's this one. It's called Quantum Frequency Technologies. Okay, seven sisters. This is the Google Play app. They also have it on Apple as well, but it looks like this. So this is the app that I've been listening to. And this, I've been telling everybody, use this app because there's a frequency for signal clearing, resets, helps you sleep, your presence, it clears your aura field, raise your vibrations, it actually helps with your 5D shielding, all types of stuff. Now, when you get further down the line, there's a few packs. These you actually have to pay for, but trust me, like I said, it's worth the payment because she's been talking to me and she said the military actually wanted her technology. But she was like, nah, I'm not giving it to y'all because they was going to use it for evil and shit like that. But there's all types of frequencies, chakras, alignments. This stuff actually helps. It's been upgrading my body for like a long time.
So there's a whole bunch of stuff. Now, she told me it was designed this way to where you have to, because the first pack, the first one that you get, Ruby, this is all free. You start off here. You need to go down the line. And then what you do next is Turquoise is like $40. Okay. So the Turquoise level is 40, and you have to do it in order. She designed it that way because, like I said, you gotta go in order. You can't jump all the way down to the bottom because you'll actually kind of fuck yourself up. Your body can't handle these heavy frequencies. So it's designed this way where you need to go down the line. And trust me, like I said, it's worth it because you pay $39 for this package, and then the next one's $59, the next one is $99. Trust me, spend the money on this. Because I talk to her all the time, and her shit is dope. So I've already bought this package, but on this phone, it's not showing. But yeah, there's this stuff is legit. And they also have a desktop version as well. They got a quantum scanner. This baby will actually scan the area around you, and it'll pick up your energy field and let you know what needs to be cleansed. And it'll give you a recommendation. Frequency healers, there's a playlist you can put together. You can select your location to the closest pyramid. So let's say these are where all the pyramids are located. So there's another, like I said, Georgia is definitely one of those grounds. But you can actually activate when you got to, like I said, pay for the package, which is well worth it. But when you... These packages actually allow you to activate the pyramids that are around you, that's closest to you, and you work with them. So these are all where the pyramids are located, all around the globe, which we all notice isn't really a globe, but, you know, and there's Antarctica right there. The sheet of ice that they don't want to fucking tell nobody about, the hollow earth, the inner earth. But yeah. Get this app. What was I listening to? This shit is fire. If you want to upgrade your body and become that superhero, I suggest you get the app. Everybody's still here? I know I hit the power button by accident. My bad, y'all. Who's still here? Yes, meditate. I don't know if you still hear Real Kings Never Die, but yes, meditate before you go to bed. Meditation is very important because, okay, good. Yeah, my bad. I fucking hit the power button. Nothing actually happens by mistake, so that was actually meant to happen. I don't know why, but it just did. But yeah, meditate before you go to bed, before you get up. Listen to these frequencies when you sleep. That's the best. When you listen to these when you sleep, your dreams are going to be dope as fuck. You're going to wake up rejuvenated. I mean, you've already said you got the app, so like, on some real shit. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, the importance of meditation. This is for people who don't know about meditation. The reason you're supposed to meditate is because you're cleansing the junk that's in your brain. Meditation helps align your chakras, which are very important. And it also cleanses like your mind to be pure. Because the problem is, like I said, what's my battery percentage? Okay, I'm good. Too many people are too busy listening to, they got too much junk in their head. They got junk DNA. Okay? The frequencies that most people have been listening to, which is if you listen to rap, if you listen to anything that was negative, you got to clear that shit out your head. When you meditate, you are clearing your head. Clearing your head is like having a blank sheet of paper. When you have a blank mind, now you have the ability to create. Because the problem is, too many people, when they watch TV, they got commercials playing in their head. They got songs playing in their head. They got shit that anything that doesn't serve them. People who didn't do their shadow work, they got all types of, you know, drama shit. Like I said, TV is not good for you because it shows you shit you're not supposed to be, you're not supposed to see, which is death. It puts fear in your hearts when you watch horror films. That's putting fear. You're basically putting those demons in your head, so you manifest them in your reality. When you, like I said, commercials, all types of shit that's in your, that's been implanted into your brain. So that's why it's good to meditate, because you need to clear that shit out of your mind, because everything that you have been shown, you are manifesting in your reality subconsciously. Consciously, you thinking that you just waking up every day, brushing your teeth, going to work, doing all this other shit. That's consciously, you think you know what you're doing. Subconscious mind is shit that's on autopilot that you don't realize. So if you got a shitty ass life, it's because subconsciously there's a bunch of junk in your head that you need to clear out in order for you to have a better life. And it's so fucking simple. All you got to do is just do the work. Listen to frequencies, meditate, talk to yourself. Give yourself hope. Give yourself life. Say the words, I am. I am is a keyword code that unlocks your mind when you say I am. I am great. You start to believe you're great. I am true. I am wise. You start to believe that you are true and you are wise. If you say the words, if you check this out, and kings never die, I'm going to teach you this shit too. If you expect, this is an example. If you expect to get money every single day and you speak it, you're going to get money every single day because you believe it. It's all about belief. Right now, many people believe, they say the words constantly, man, I'm broke. I'm broke as a joke. Man, I ain't got no money. Man, that's too expensive. I can't afford this. You're putting all these spells in your head that's creating your reality to suck. But if you take the time to listen to frequencies and you tell yourself every single day, even if you don't believe it, it's called tricking yourself. You need to trick your subconscious mind. Trick yourself into believing that you are prosperous and you will attract it. For example, my crystal business. My crystal business is successful because in my meditation, I imagine people running to buy from me. And I've done it so much that my mind already expects that people are going to buy from me. So pretty much every single week I'm making sales, because it's not about the hard work. Yes, I am putting in hard work, but I'm doing what I love. And when you do what you love, you get that energy. You know how you have a good time and all of a sudden time flies? First of all, time doesn't exist. But whenever you're having a good time, the reason they say time flies when you're having fun is because, one, time don't exist. Two, you're not thinking about the time. So what's going on is you're in your element. You're in your energy. So when your energy is high, you can manifest because your energy is high as fuck. You're in the clouds. You're in the ether. So you can manifest whatever you want because your energy is up there. So I always do this as well. When you go to the store and you buy something, at the register, say the words, the money that I spend, I will get 10 times back. I do that every time I go to the store. I say those words and I imagine when I spend money, it's not leaving my bank account. It's actually money is coming into my bank account. Most people, when they spend money, they're thinking about, I got bills to pay. Damn, I'm about to lose out on some funds. Damn, I just lost out on this amount of money. So therefore, your brain gives you what you're being pissed off about. But when you spend money and you already know in your head, I'm gonna get this shit right back today. As a business owner for myself, I always know that I end up attracting. Like I said, I don't, people buy my, whenever I get anything expensive, I end up, somebody will come to me randomly and be like, yo, I want an order of this. So anytime I wanted a cell phone or, you know, and I only reason I had to upgrade a cell phone is because, like I said, it's not that necessarily the technology is bad, it's how you use it. So I ended up getting a cell phone. My homie ended up paying me back, so he paid for the cell phone, really. I needed to pay something else, and next thing you know, somebody hit me up for a crown, so they paid my bill. So like I said, every time you pay for something, your reality, your brain is automatically tuned to the frequency that you always gonna be prosperous. So therefore, you never gonna run out of money, and you never gonna be broke again, because you got it in your head constantly, because you tell yourself every single day, I'm rich, I'm prosperous. You see that shit. You see in your mind that your bank account is always full. Shit, even if you want to take a screenshot of your bank statement and write $1 million in your bank account, you can do that. Just edit the photo out. Take a screenshot of your bank statement, white out the thing, and put that you got $1 million or $10,000 or whatever it is in your bank account. And every time you look at your phone, your brain is being processed. And what's going on is you're programming your mind to believe that you got that $10,000 or $1 million in your bank account, because you see the photo. You know what your bank account looks like. So when you actually put something for you to look at every single day, you're gonna attract that money to come to you, whether it's a job opportunity, whatever it is. Everything, like I said, is so magical in this universe. All you gotta do is write that shit out, burn it, say thank you to the universe, thank you to your higher self, show an attitude of gratitude, and you're gonna get exactly what you want. Yeah, these messages are for you. You're not here by mistake. Real kings never die. I think, matter of fact, I think you're the only one who I only see one person, so it's not no mistake that you came back. There's no such thing as coincidences. I'm gonna teach you all that shit. So if I were you, I would suggest you book an hour-long session with me, because I'm gonna drop a lot of fucking knowledge to you. 30 minutes, I can give you enough in 30 minutes, but I'm just really suggesting you an hour with me. You get a lot of fucking codes from me. So when we talk, bring a pencil and a pad, because I got all the goddamn gems. I'm basically Morpheus in this bitch, but I have the abilities of Neo, so it's gonna be lit. All right, I'm good for tonight. I've talked my ass off as always. So, for those who are still here, I appreciate you watching. For those who are watching, and it's not live, peace to the Middle East, as always. Always together, never apart. West side be the best side. Live long and prosper. I close the portals of one side, so you all take your energy back. I close the portal on my end, so I take back my energy. Be truthful, be honest. I love every single one of y'all. Your greatness, always speak it. Only think about what you want as an end result, and I will see y'all on the flip side. Please share this video. Get this message out to everybody, because this is gems that everybody needs to find out. And I will see y'all. I'll see you when I see you. Much love.